Hello everyone, my name is Ishmael and in today's video I feel inspired, you know, to share with you five of the things that you should watch out for, the tricks that the enemy is trying to use against you so you don't receive your promise or that you miss out on the promise that God has for you. So of course with this I have five things that I want you to be aware of and I want to warn you about, because I know that many people will fall victim to this if they are not aware. And even right now as I'm speaking, there's still many more every day that are falling victim. So the first three will be related with relationship or marriage related things, of course. So it's not all about marriages, I just want you to be aware. And then the final two will be related to something different outside marriage related things. So whether you're interested in marriage or non-married things, please watch, this could be important for you. So one of the first things that the enemy is doing that you should be aware of is, for example, like when people they meet somebody that they are into, they tend to lose interest, you know. And sometimes it's not a matter of it's like somehow they get caught up at a moment where like their emotions are just all over and they just feel like they don't really need that marriage, and most of the time, or they don't need that person. In fact, that was the potential person for them to get married with, but somehow their minds get deceived by the enemy, of course, and it makes them lose interest and feel like, nah, this is not the right person, or maybe I'm not ready for this relationship, God is gonna bring somebody better, only to find out some time after they only get to regret and realize that person I missed out. Why didn't I say yes, or why didn't I go through with it? Because this person had interest. That's why some people will end up going back into people's lives, because now they are starting to regret, because now they see the value of those people. Okay, so also beware of that. Make sure before you say no, or before you refuse, you shut away a chance at being with somebody whom you realize you've been praying about, especially character wise or, you know, like something, most of the thing, because the only thing that gets in the way, you find that is the feelings at the moment. But you find that at the moment you don't feel like it, and you feel like, yeah, that's it, and you end up making it the decision that determines your whole future, you know. So please be careful, think twice, be sure before you say that, okay, I don't want to go through this relationship, especially for those who are expecting our kingdom marriages, their spouse and all. Look for out for this. It's not necessarily that you will find somebody and you feel those butterflies, okay? You will find somebody but still feel like you're not so interested, only to find out as time goes, if you give it a shot, you fall in love with them, and that's how it happens. So the second thing that I want you to be aware of is all of a sudden you find that someone is right in front of your eyes. Most of the time you don't see it when it's something real. Most people, they miss it, and the enemy does this every day. You know, as Christians, real committed Christian guys, I even have friends, you find that he likes a certain lady at church and she looks so committed, but the moment he gives her some attention, she doesn't love him back. But some years later, you still realize this lady is still struggling with finding the right person. And as for me, as a friend, or knowing that person better, I was like, she was so lucky to get this guy, you know, this is a very good guy, a well committed Christian. Like, I believe every girl when she is, or every lady when they are praying for a spouse, this is the character that I describe. But most of these people, you know, it is real, they don't see it, they don't see it. I think even with goes with men, they don't see it when they are with a good lady. That's why some they cheat only to regret later. So please, most of the time God brings those people or something that we want in right in front of our eyes, but the enemy distract us and make us to lose focus and feel like, nah, now we take it for granted that there's always somebody better, and only to find that we realize we think that the grass is greener outside, but only to realize that it only gets tougher. So please watch out for that, okay? And now let's number three, before we go to those other ones, the final two. Number three, like friends, close people to you, like some people, they miss out on the special people that God has ordained for them because of pressure. You find that at the moment, remember, like, somebody today might not be rich, but remember that somebody might not be rich at this moment, but in the future, as time goes on, few months down the drain, they will be so loaded, they will have all those things, you know. So friends, they tend to discourage people, and you find that the moment you find somebody, or you start wanna get to know somebody, tell friends, and friends be like, yo, this guy is ugly, or this girl is ugly, you know, or no, he doesn't have money, he doesn't have this and that, and then they lose interest. But only to find a year after, that very same person that you felt like was not loaded enough financially, now he has his life altogether. That lady thought she's ugly or not good looking. Now she knows how to dress well. Now she has a money, because money does work, you know. Somebody knows just fine. At the moment, they can't do their hair. They can't do so a lot. I've seen it with my own eyes. I've seen people, like, in the beginning, whom, when I got to know, even friends especially, you find out, I was like, okay. But after some years, like, yeah, this lady has really transformed, you know, more transforming, like, you can see, like, she's a different being. So I realized people change. It's one of the lessons that I was, like, always told myself, like, you know what, I will never make a mistake of maybe, like, I get a shot at a lady and then I realize that maybe she's not as good looking as I would prefer, but not realizing, but she's not bad. I will never really, really say no just because I'm looking at her at the present moment. My mindset is, should always be to picture her. Now, when she knows how to do makeup, how to dress much better and all those, because you let her go, by the time she's more good looking, less likely will she come back to you. That's one thing I said, I disciplined myself about, was like, I should never make such a mistake in my life. So I hope you also teach yourself the same thing. Even you ladies with men, just look at somebody who has a vision and forget about friends. Friends, remember, even when you have problems, they are the first one to say, dump the person. Dump the person. They are quick to come up with hasty decisions. But then with them, you realize the man is even abusing her, is beating her up, but she's not leaving him. But she's telling you to leave a man just because he didn't pick up your phone, or he didn't ignore you for a day. But he's been doing worse. So friends, watch out for that. Also, now let's go to the fourth one. Now let's speak about the enemy likes. Have you noticed sometimes you've been found that you've been looking for a job for some time, for so long, and then finally you find that job, but then suddenly you lose this interest. It has happened to me before, and even to some other people. I've even remember my sister some years ago. There was a time she was looking for a job, but then finally when she found it, she was like, nah, but I'm no longer sure if I still want this job, you know. So, like, I realized at the point of breakthrough, the enemy always brings something that makes you feel like, ah, you know what, let me just forget about this. But then only to, after you decided not to take the job, to regret. Not only for talking about jobs, different things. Before you make a decision, when you finally find a breakthrough, the enemy makes you lose interest in something. And please, and I know that there are some many people who fall for that and be like, ah, you know what, I was comfortable not working, maybe I'll find something even better, and then they sit only to realize no better opportunity ever comes, and they only live to regret, you know. So beware, please do not also fall victim to that, okay? As well as finally, when it comes to giving up at the point of breakthrough, the enemy is good at that. You've been praying, fasting and all, but at the point of breakthrough, you find that if it's a matter of now, like, you, like, you find that at finally you've been waiting. Sometimes it takes years, you know, for breakthrough, like testimonies, you know, like people who testify, you realize they've went through a lot. But then you find that the enemy makes it upon that at the point of breakthrough, you give up. How do you give up? Some people, mainly because, not necessarily when you don't no longer pray about something so long. No, you find some people, they end up consulting, finding other means to get help. Some, if it's a lady, she becomes a prostitute. Some, if they consult maybe witch doctors for assistance. That's the kind of giving up I'm talking about. You know, if it's sometimes some people, they end up even stealing. Like, you change drastically. I'm not talking about where you lose whole faith and feel like, I know what, I'm tired of praying. No, there God, I've realized through experience as well, that God still comes through for you. It's not like you've really, really given up on Him. It's just that you're just tired at the moment, and it will just surprise you. I like telling people that even if you feel like, you've been praying for so long, that never really makes God angry. The only thing that makes God angry is when you start to source for other help, find other help at some other places outside God Himself. So please beware, the enemy is trying to trick you. Please watch out, okay? In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. May your eyes be opened up. May the Holy Spirit help you to discern and avoid and dodge all the tricks of the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I seal this prayer with the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you know every time I upload new videos like this. Like today's video if you feel blessed with it, and share with those whom you feel might need to hear this. And for prayer requests, you can DM me on my Instagram or in my email. The details are on the description of the video below. Also, I do interpret dreams and many more. Please feel free to contact me and give me time to get back to you, as I have so many emails, comments, DMs. So yes, eventually I will come back to you, even if I take some time, okay? I'm still working on how to be faster and responding and all, but be patient. I will eventually respond. And as for me, Ishmael, and your priest, I will see you in the next video upload. Take care and stay blessed.